Hello friend, today I have taken one topic from modern India. The name of the topic is Drain of Wealth Theory. Dadabhai Nowroji is associated with this Drain of Wealth Theory. This theory explains how the economic exploitation was made by British government. This theory is also related with economic nationalism. This theory has created economic nationalism in India. This theory also plays very important role in India's freedom struggle movement. In his 1888 lectures, Sir John Strachey explained the mechanism of drain of wealth with clarity and frankness. During this period, Britishers were following the mercantilist policy. What is mercantilist policy? This mercantilist policy has two characteristics. The first characteristic is the Britishers were trying to increase their export. The second characteristic is through this export, Britishers were trying to accumulate more and more gold and silver. By that period, that is in 19th century, it was said that those countries which accumulates more and more gold were supposed to be the more and more strong. Now, we discuss how drain of wealth of India used to take place. First, British purchasers of Indian exports were buying council bills from Secretary of State who was residing in England. These council bills were then exchanged for Indian rupee from Government of India's revenue. These rupee were then used by British merchants to buy Indian goods for exports. British exporters were then selling their products in England and earning pound sterling. Now, the Government of India had the council bills, which were deposited by the British merchants. These council bills were deposited by Government of India to Exchange Bank of United Kingdom and getting pound sterling. Here, from the 1870 onwards, the silver rupee depreciated in terms of gold standard pound sterling. So, as the Indian rupee was depreciated in terms of gold standard pound sterling, the British merchants of Indian exports got handsome return. Again, because of depreciation of Indian silver rupee, Government of India was also getting benefit. So, Government of India could now easily discharge their home charges by paying pound sterling. What were the home charges? Home charges included pension to British Indian officials and army officers. Military and other stores purchased in England, cost of army training, transport and campaign outside India. To conclude, both home charges and private remittances were thus paid through Indian exports and so the drain of wealth of India. The originally mercantilist drain had become closely associated with the process of exploitation through free trade and with the structure of British Indian finance capitalism. Through all this discussion, we can easily understand how the British fiscal deficit was financed through the surplus export of India, and this helps to make the industrialization of England very successful. Thank you for watching my video.